I'm Will Donzella, Product Specialist for Sterilization at Heidolph North America. In today's video, we will cover how to properly load your liquid media into Heidolph's lab line autoclaves using the model 2840 ELP, which comes with two integrated probes for complete sterilization. For this video, I will be referencing the liquid A cycle, which comes pre-programmed on all lab line autoclaves. The liquid A cycle is a 15-minute sterilization at 121 degrees Celsius. Lab line autoclaves sterilize liquids based on the internal temperature of the liquid using the probes that are located within the chamber. This means that the unit will not move into the sterilization stage until the internal temperature of the liquid has reached that necessary sterilization temperature, in our case, 121 degrees Celsius. This means that you do not have to create custom cycles based on the size of the vessel you are using or the amount of liquid that is being sterilized. The unit will just automatically move into that sterilization stage once the internal temperature of the liquid has reached 121 degrees Celsius. Now let's go over the process for sterilizing liquids. The first step is to turn on your unit and select the appropriate cycle. On 2840 models, the power switch can be found on the right-hand side of the unit. On all other lab line models, the power switch is located under the printer. Once you have the unit turned on, you can then use the up and down arrow keys to select the appropriate cycle. You can only do this with the door open. I have the liquid A cycle selected here, and you can see two different temperatures on the screen as well as a pressure. The temperatures that are displayed are the temperatures of the probes themselves, and the pressure is the pressure that is being read within the chamber. The next step is to prep your media. When sterilizing liquids, we do not recommend filling any vessel more than two-thirds of the way full. And the reason for this is that in the event that there is boil over, it does not boil over out of the vessel into the autoclave, which can then damage the unit. If contamination is a concern, we recommend using a control vessel of water to put the probes in to monitor the temperature of the liquid during the process. This control vessel needs to be filled with the same amount of water as the vessel with the maximum amount of your media in it. Let me show you what I mean. I got two different size flasks here with my media in it. I got a liter flask with 350 milliliters of my media in it and a 250 milliliter flask with 100 milliliters of my media in it. Here's my control vessel, my control flask with water in it. It's got 350 milliliters of water in it to match that larger volume of my media. This way, when I stick the probes in that control vessel, I'm monitoring the temperature of that larger volume and then ensuring that the temperature of that large volume reaches the proper sterilization temperature, which therefore would mean this smaller volume has also reached that sterilization temperature. We do recommend trying to keep the size of the vessel and the volume of media being sterilized as close to the same as possible, and the reason for this is to help avoid boil over. If you are sterilizing any heat sensitive media, all lab line autoclaves come with the option to add additional software called the F-sub-zero cycle. This cycle helps to prevent damage to your media. When loading your media, if it is necessary to cap each vessel, you can do so, just please make sure to put the cap on very loosely so that a pressure does not build up within the vessel, causing it to burst. You do not need to cap the control vessel, as this is just where the probes are going to go, but if you would like to do so, you can, just again, please make sure it is loose. For this demonstration, I will not be capping my media. Now that you have prepped your media, you're good to start loading your autoclave. Please make sure to put your media in the back of the unit and the control vessel as far to the front. The reason for that is because the probes are located at the front and it's way easier to just stick them in that control vessel if it's located at the front. It also makes unloading the autoclave much easier. We want to make sure that both temperature probes are put in the same vessel. This is because the probes are used to confirm the reading of each other to help ensure successful sterilization. Thank you for watching this video. I'm Will Donzella, Product Specialist for Sterilization at Heidolph North America. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us at the information below.